So imagine this, you've just returned from your dream beach holiday and it was glorious, but now it's over and you're feeling a little bit irritable and a little bit bloated and a little bit sleepy. You're probably suffering from jet lag. The first mention of the term jet lag was made by Horace Sutton in 1966 in the Los Angeles Times. He said that jets travel so fast that they leave your body rhythms behind. And you know what? He was actually pretty close to the mark. Human bodies are governed by circadian clocks. These clocks keep our internal systems in an almost exactly 24-hour repeating pattern. This means that my body has a good sense of when it's time to get up and when it's time to go to sleep. It has a rhythm. If I'm then to take my body and send it, say, from London to Los Angeles, what was bedtime in London is now mid-afternoon, and my body is effectively 8 hours out of whack. Now, your body's rhythm is actually really good at regulating itself, but it does respond to external cues, such as sunlight. Changes in light trigger your body to release melatonin, which is the sleep hormone. To understand this process, we have to start with our eyes. Our eyes have three types of light-sensitive cells: rods, cones, and photosensitive ganglion cells. The first two are well known for allowing us to see, but it's the third type that we're interested in now because they affect our circadian rhythms. Photosensitive ganglion cells can detect how bright it is and let our circadian clock know whether it's day or night based on that. When light hits these cells, they absorb photons and release neurotransmitters. The neurotransmitters trigger nerve impulses that travel directly into the suprachiasmatic nucleus. This is the region of the brain that acts as our circadian clock. The clock interprets the pulses and, if necessary, signals the pineal gland that it's time to start secreting melatonin. Scientists have shown that you can shift your body's rhythm by 1 to 2 hours using light without physical side effects. So how can we use this information to help us counter the effects of jet lag? Well, all you actually need to do is pre-adjust your body's internal clock, and it's pretty simple. If, for example, I'm traveling east, all I need to do is go to bed 1 hour earlier than I usually would 2 days before I travel. I also need to seek out bright lights in the morning, because don't forget, light and jet lag are connected together, because light triggers our body's melatonin, the sleep hormone. 1 day before I travel, I need to increase this by 1 hour. So instead of going to bed at my usual time, I'm going to bed 2 hours before that. I keep changing this by adding an hour every day, even while I'm traveling, until I get to my usual sleep time, and then you can stop. If you're going west, all you do is do the opposite. By doing this, you can greatly reduce, if not eliminate, the effects of jet lag. Now, you might hate jet lag, but actually it's just a temporary issue for you that comes up whenever you go on holidays. Spare a thought for astronauts, because for astronauts, this is potentially a really big headache. Future Mars colonists are going to need to use training methods like the ones I've just shown you to prepare their bodies, because at 24.65 hours, the Mars day is just long enough to knock their bodies off kilter.